Hi, I'm Dr. Tom Casale. I'm the Chief Medical Advisor for FARA, and what I'd like to do today is to address a question that we often get, and that is, why is there an increase in food allergy, and why is there an association between food allergy and asthma? Well, we know that in the United States, about 8% of children and up to 11% of adults actually have food allergy, and that number is increasing. There are a lot of potential mechanisms for this, but we know that there are at least three that most people agree on. Number one, if you have a genetic predisposition, that is, if you have a first degree relative with an allergy, especially a food allergy, you're more likely to have a food allergy yourself. The second is a change in the gut microbiome. The gut microbiome is the microbes that live in your intestinal tract. When you eat food and it goes into the intestinal tract, those bacteria break it down in a certain way and make you tolerant to those foods. That is, you don't develop allergies. We know that with Western cultures, like in the United States, with an increase in sanitation, vaccines, antibiotics, etc., that those microbes have changed, and they've changed in a way that they may cause some underlying inflammation in the gut so that those food allergens can escape into the bloodstream and set up an immune response or an allergic reaction. The third mechanism that appears to happen is exposure of food into the skin. So again, if you have atopic dermatitis or atopic eczema, you're more likely to develop food allergy, and that's probably because the food proteins can actually get absorbed through the skin and cause an allergic type of immune response. So those three mechanisms are very important. Why the association between food allergy and asthma? If you have food allergy, you're 2 to 4 times more likely to be one of the 26 million Americans that have asthma. And that association is such that if you have food allergy, you're also more likely to have more severe asthma, uncontrolled asthma. Conversely, if you have an anaphylactic reaction or a severe reaction to food, and you have asthma, you're more likely to have a severe event because the lung is already inflamed from the asthma and it's more of a target organ for an anaphylactic event. I hope these answers help you in understanding food allergy and asthma. Thank you.